Hi guys, here what you see is a 12 volts car alternator, 12 volts 64 amperes. You can see that at the back of it there is no 3-phase rectifier because I took it out since I converted this into a 3-phase brushless DC motor. And one of my previous videos, these two wires for the brushes are still here, blue and red as you can see. So I've made a lot of videos using this alternator. So what's new about this video is that an alternator is designed to produce 12 volts. And that 12 volts is DC, which is converted to DC with the help of a 3-phase bridge rectifier. But what I'm going to do in this video is modify the armature winding and connect all of it in series to increase the voltage at the same RPM. Now the target is to achieve 3 times the voltage, the present voltage, which is 12 volts. So 12, 3 is a 36, meaning 36 volts. Although because of the diodes, some of the voltage will get lost in the forward biasing condition, but the left out voltage will still be around 30 volts, 25 to 30 volts, which is much more than usual voltage. Now guys, a car alternator produces 12 volts at an RPM of around 2000 or more, and my target is to produce around 30 to 36 volts at 2000 RPM. And since voltage is directly proportional to RPM, so I can achieve 12 volts at 3 times less than rated RPM. So if a car alternator is designed to produce 12 volts at 2000 RPM, I can produce 12 volts by that modification at just 2000 divided by 3, which is somewhere around 700 RPM. So guys, let's open it up and modify it. So guys, here as you can see that the base of the alternator has opened, and now comes the modification part, winding modification. Okay. So guys, this is the fan that you see, this bearing that you see, and these two slip rings that you see, these are all the rotor parts. And the bearing of the rotor, as you can see, is very smooth, the front one, and this is the lower one. This is also working pretty good. And these four are the wires coming out from the armature winding. You can see these three thick wires. These are actually designed to generate high current to charge the car or truck batteries. Now among these four, there is one tapping point because it is a star connected winding. Since this terminal is the thicker one, so the probability is high for the tapping point to be this one. So let's remove it. Yeah, as you can see that this is the soldering. I'll give a closer view. So guys, here you can see the tapping point. The remaining three are normal. This one, all the wires are coming on and joining at this point. So what I have to do is desolder it and remove the tapping. Okay, so guys, here what you see are three separate windings. Now guys, the armature winding of this alternator contains three separate windings. Now you see here six wires. Okay, 1, 2, 3, the smaller one, 4, 5, and 6. Now these six wires are from three coils. So we have to separate the three coils by doing continuity check with multimeter. So let's do that. Okay, moving the pointer towards continuity mode. Now I've already done the test, so this wire and this wire, you can see they are connected to each other. We'll remove this from background. Okay, then this wire and this wire, they are in continuity, and then this wire and this wire, they are in continuity. So I have to connect three different colored wires to the three windings, three different windings. Okay, so let's do that. All the wires are ready for soldering. Now comes the part of these. Yeah, as can be seen, it has been soldered pretty good. So guys, now comes the wiring, the same colored wiring. So I'm taking this one as black. Okay, this one as red. Yeah, this one has also got connected. And let's take this one as green. So yeah, this is also done. Okay, now comes the remaining three. So guys, this one was part of this one, so this is also to be connected with black color, black colored wire. So yeah, black has been connected. This one was for the red. This one is also connected. Now this one is for the green. Yeah, so this one is also connected. Now comes the rectification process. So guys, as you can see that all the wires have been isolated from each other, and these heat shrink tubes have to be heated up, and everything seems to be fine right now. Okay, so let's start with that. Okay, this seems fine. So guys, it's time to replace the brushes back at the back of this alternator again. Okay, so guys, now the wiring has been done and also space has been created for installing the new wires, although it has been cut a little more than it was intended. So anyways, let's install it. And now it is ready to be installed. So the tricky part is to adjust brushes. So guys, to connect the brushes back again, all you have to do is push them inside and keep them held back with a metal or thin metal piece or oil pin. Okay, so one is already in, as you can see, the other one is held back. Okay, so guys, the case has been installed as before. Now I have to remove this metal wire to make the brush get in contact with the slip ring. Okay, so now it's in contact. Okay, so I have to place the screws back in their slots. So let's do that. And tighten it up. Okay, so guys, the alternator is all set for testing. So guys, here as you can see are all the phase wires. So the phase wires will be connected in series to increase the overall armature winding voltage per phase. So three phases will be connected in series. Since green and green represent one phase and red represent one phase. So let's connect green and red in series. Okay, so connecting these two together. And then because of the Murphy's law, I will have to connect this one. And the remaining one is this one. And then again, because of the Murphy's law, it is going to be this one. So finally, the two wires coming out from the alternator, single phase AC, are going to be green and black. So guys, here as you can see that I'm using a UPS battery, 12 volts, a 7H chloride. So I've connected the terminals from the UPS battery to the brush slip ring terminals, red and blue. Although one wire is not connected, that I will connect afterwards. And the wires from the alternator have been connected in series, and the final output is appearing on this green wire and this black wire. So here what I have is a multimeter pointing towards 200 volts AC mode to measure the generated voltage from the alternator. So let's do the connections and do the test. Okay, black to black, although it does not matter because the voltage coming out from the alternator is going to be AC, so polarity does not matter at the moment. So the wires have been connected, meter is pointing towards 0.0 volts, and one wire from the lead acid battery has been connected to the brushes. Now let's connect the other wire too and then move the shaft to see some generated voltage and see how much I can generate with simple hand rotation. And after that, I'm going to do some rope rotation. So 0 volts. So maximum that I did was 3 volts with hand rotation. Now comes the rope rotation test. Now, although the alternator requires around 2000 RPM to achieve 12 volts, so if I am capable of rotating the shaft at just 600 RPM, I should reach a voltage of somewhere around 12 or 13 volts DC. So let's try that. Okay, the thread has been wound. Now I have to touch the terminal to the battery. Okay, the connection has been made. Keep watching the screen. Whoa. So guys, as you saw that I generated around 14 volts AC with the help of this alternator with simple rope rotation, which is really awesome, which means that the series connection, the modification that I did are actually working. A little higher RPM, somewhere around 2000, and it is going to produce 36 volts. 14 volts is pretty good, with which you can charge your car batteries or any other battery at simple low RPM. And also guys, the major drawback with alternators, as we all know it, is the RPM to achieving the 12 volts. And at a lower RPM, the brushes installed to the slip rings are going to wear off at three times lesser rate. So it elongates the brush life also. Now let's connect some actual load to it. So guys, this is the Royal Enfield headlamp bulb that I'm going to use to connect to this alternator and test its power. Connecting this wire. Okay, go. So once again, removing this wire, it is going to get heat up. Okay, so guys, this is a single phase rectifier, 35 amperes, which I'm going to connect. So as you can see here, the plus positive terminal, and this is the AC. The black and red are the AC. If this one is AC, then the diagonal opposite is also AC. So these two will be connected to the black and green terminal from the alternator. One is done. Comes the second one. That also is done. Now finally, the output will be DC and will appear on blue and black. So let's connect a meter again. So guys, as you can see, I've connected the rectifier and the terminals of the meter, and now it is pointing towards 20 volts DC mode. Although this brushes and the rotor system has not been excited, I will connect the wires. So I wound the thread. Now it's time to connect the blue terminal, the rotor winding. Okay, that being done, watch the meter screen. So it was 11.5 volts DC. A little bit voltage went because of the forward biasing, around 1.4 volts. And now guys, since the output is DC, I can also measure the output current since I have changed the winding connections. Let's see the impact of that. The current should reduce to half because of the series connection. Although half is still a lot considering the current rating of this alternator, it is 64 amperes divided by 3, it is going to be around 21 amperes, which is obviously not what I'm going to produce with the rope rotation test. It is not practically possible, but I'm telling you the calculations. Okay, then I have to hold it pretty tight because the current is going to stop me from rotating the shaft. Okay. Watch the screen. Around 5.81 amperes is what I produced by the rope rotation test. So the total power that I produced was around 12 volts and 5.8 taking it 6, making it 12 cross 6, 72 watts. Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit that bell icon for similar video notifications. Also, do comment on what else you would like me to add to this present video. Best regards, Electron.